As I mentioned, the patient position, it is sitting or standing. Therapist position is beside the patient, next to the patient. Can you come there? Okay? It will go back, otherwise you will fall. Okay. So, beside the patient. My position is beside the patient. Now, there is something called fulcrum. Where I should put the fulcrum, the center point of the goniometer. If you move this fulcrum, then range of motion will go away. So, the fulcrum for shoulder flexion, extension, abduction, adduction is same. Only one fulcrum. That is called acromion process. Okay, you know scapula? This is scapula. Yes. The spine is scapula. Fulcrum. That means you should put the goniometer there for doing flexion extension. Okay, so that will be the fulcrum for the. How to palpate the fulcrum? Palpate the clavicle. Okay, come to the end of the clavicle. So that will be the acromion process. Okay. Keep the fulcrum at the acromion process. Now next is movable arm. Which is movable arm in this? This is movable arm. Movable arm should be parallel to the arm, that is humerus. Movable arm should be parallel to the humerus. Stationary arm is in the middle line for the axilla. Trunk, there is a midline. So this should be on the midline of the axilla. So now patient position sitting or standing. Therapist position beside the patient. Fulcrum, acromion process. Mobile arm to the humerus. Okay. Stationary arm, midline to the body or mid axillary line. Now, sits right? Yes. Now you see the starting range where you are starting. See, now I am starting at 40. Okay. Otherwise it will be, see, now it is 0. Okay.
Yes.
Now from here, can you move your hand to the flexion like this? Okay. Slowly. Can you move now? Move. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Little slowly. Okay. Sit straight. Yeah, start. So now 180.
Yes.
From 0 to 180 degrees. Okay? So that is flexion. Extension. Again, same position. Patient position sitting. Therapist position beside the patient, fulcrum acromion process, mobile arm humerus, stationary arm mid axillary line. Now you have to move the arm backwards like this. Okay? Yeah. Move. 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 Don't lean forward. Body straight? Yes. That's it. That's it. I started 0 and I went up to 70.
Yes.
So, extension 0 to 70 degrees. Okay, for him. But normally it may go up to 50 degrees. 0 to 50 to 70 is normal. Okay, for flexion, 0 degrees to 180 degrees is flexion. Now, we'll see abduction, abduction. Okay. Now, for measuring abduction adduction, I should come in front of the patient. Okay? My position will change. Acromion process, that is same. Okay? For the fulcrum. The mobile arm is same for the humerus. Stable arm is parallel to the trunk. Okay? Trunk. Parallel to the trunk in a straight line. Yeah, that will work. So, acromion process, patient position sitting, therapist position in front of the patient, fulcrum, acromion process, mobile arm to the humerus, the stable arm parallel to the body, okay, beside the body, parallel to the body, acromion process, yeah, it is zero, okay, starting is zero.
Yes.
Now can you do abduction? Yeah. Up. Very good. More. Turn the hand, turn, up, go up, 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 okay. So this is 180 degrees, okay. Abduction, the important point what you have to remember when you do abduction is, any patient, what is this? You know what is this? Humerus. Greater trochanter, greater tubercle, lesser tubercle. This is greater tubercle and this is lesser tubercle. Now, when you move, actually what happens is, when you do abduction, okay, after 90 degrees of abduction, the greater tubercle comes in contact with the acromion process. Okay?
Yes.
Greater tubercle comes in contact with the acromion process. So that time you don't have range of motion and it will impinge, that means crush some of the muscles. Okay? Especially supraspinatus muscle, it will crush. So after 90 degrees of shoulder abduction, for any patient, you should ask them to externally rotate. Okay? When you externally rotate, what happens? The humerus head will roll like this and it will go to the full abduction. Okay? So the important thing is, after 90 degrees of abduction, ask the patient to turn the hand upwards, then move it up. Then you will get the full range of motion. Otherwise, you will stuck here only. Can everybody do abduction without rolling? Abduction? Don't move. Abduction, do full. Possible? Now roll, turn the hand, which is easy. After turning it will be easy, okay? This is biomechanics, this is normal anatomics. So when you move the joint, after abduction, you have to move it into external rotation, then move fully, okay? So that is abduction. Now for adduction, the shoulder is already in abduction. Now from here, you will get back to the full, whether acromion process, parallel to the arm. Can you come down? Down, down, down. Okay. So that will be usually full. Okay. So that means 180 degrees of abduction to 0 degrees. Most of the patients, 99% of the patients, don't have problem in adduction. Usually adduction will be good. There is no restriction in the adduction. Again, 95% of the patients, the problem is with the abduction. Okay? So you should know importantly how to measure the abduction rather than the adduction. Okay? So now we completed flexion, extension, abduction, adduction. Okay? Four movements we completed. Two more movements, that is internal rotation and external rotation. So for this, the good position is lie down. Can you lie down supine? Lie down on your back. Come down. Okay. Now, to measure rotations, you should keep the arm in 90 degrees of abduction. You should keep the arm in 90 degrees of abduction. Forearm in supinated position. Okay, this is pronation, this is supination. Forearm should be in supinated position. Here fulcrum is olecranon process. Okay, fulcrum is olecranon process. This is called olecranon process. Elbow, the ulna, head of the ulna will have olecranon process. The fulcrum is olecranon process. Movable arm parallel to the forearm. Movable arm parallel to the forearm, the mid of the forearm. Fulcrum, olecranon process. Stable arm is perpendicular to the floor. Okay, stable arm is perpendicular to the floor. Now move the hand towards down. This is internal rotation. So from 180 or 0, I am going inwards. That's it. Okay. 180 to 110. That means 70 degrees. Mm-hmm. Okay. If you want, I will show from other side. You can see. Patient position 2 point. I am beside the patient. Like this. Okay. For your convenience, I am standing here. Otherwise, my position is here. And whenever you measure the goniometer, your eye level should be exactly to the goniometer. Not like this, not like this. Okay? It should be in front of your eye so that measurement will be accurate. Okay? So that's why I am bending like this. So which is 90 degrees of external rotation, 70 degrees of internal rotation. So usually keep your hands like this, everybody. Okay, this is the mid position, like this, mid position. Internal rotation, external rotation. Which is easy?
External
is easy? See external, which has more range? External. Okay, external will have more range. This has 90 degrees and this has 70 degrees. So okay, this is about the shoulder. Now next one movement for elbow, flexion and extension. When you measure the elbow, you can sit down. Where is the major joint of elbow? Between radius and humerus or ulna and humerus? Between ulna and humerus. That is the major part of elbow joint. So here, can you see this? This is called olecranon fossa. Okay? And this is olecranon process. So when it goes and touches the bone, it will stop the range of motion. So end fill is hard end fill for elbow extension.
Yes.
For flexion it is soft end fill. Muscles will touch. Now for this, the fulcrum, can you see this? This is called epicondyle. Epicondyle. Okay. This particular part is called as lateral epicondyle, where there is origin of all the extensors. All the extensors of wrist, they start from here. That is called as lateral epicondyle. The flexors of the wrist, they start from medial epicondyle. Okay. So here for us, for moving elbow, the fulcrum is lateral epicondyle. This bone is structured. So we'll position the patient. We'll go there only. Can you go there? Little more. Yeah. Little more here because I want it to be straight. Yes. Okay. The hand should be in this position. Neither should be pronation, nor should be mid-prone. It should be in supinated position. Then you will do elbow flexion. So in the supinated position, the fulcrum is olecranon. The fulcrum is lateral epicondyle. Okay, how to palpate lateral epicondyle? Can you open this? If you see the bulge, lateral side bulge, okay, yes. This is the depression. If you go there and palpate, okay, this is what is lateral epicondyle. Okay, can you turn the hand again? Turn. Okay. So now I palpated the lateral epicondyle. I'll keep the fulcrum on the lateral epicondyle. Okay. Now stable arm is for the humerus. Okay. Mobile arm to the ulna. Okay. Mobile arm to the ulna. Now I'll do starting from 180 degrees.
Yes.
Okay. I'll do flexion. It went up to 40. That means how much? 60 plus 80. 140 degrees of elbow flexion. Okay? That is what he has. 140 degrees of flexion he has. Extension will be opposite. From flexion, you will measure the extension. From complete flexion, okay, you measure the extension. So it is 0.
Yes.
Okay? Now, most of the time, there is something called lag. L-A-G. Lag. Lag means after the surgery or after something, injury or something, patient is not able to move it fully. Okay? He is able to move here. So how many more degrees he should get? For example, he is a patient. His full range is this one. Okay? But after surgery or after fracture or after injury, he has only this much. So how much more to get?
Maybe
okay, so four. That you have to measure. Maybe this is, wait, this is full?
Yes.
Okay, from here to here. 180 to 130, that means around 50 degrees of lag is there for complete extension. Or 50 degrees of lag is there for complete range of motion. So, as a therapist, your duty is to decrease the lag, to improve the range of motion. Okay?
Yes.
So, the how to improve, we'll be learning in next classes, that is called manipulations and mobilizations, where you will mobilize the joint and you will try to improve the range of motion of the joint. Okay? So, that will be in the next classes. So, today, I want everybody to divide into two people. Okay, and practice,
yeah, you can close.
And practice shoulder 6 movements and elbow 2 movements. Okay, start. Take the good. The fulcrum for flexion and first patient position, it can be standing like this, or patient can sit down and keep the hand like this on the table. Okay. But it should be supported. The forearm should be supported. The therapist position beside the patient. Fulcrum for the range of motion is pisiform bone. Fulcrum is pisiform bone. Can I have the skeleton? Where is the skeleton? Where is the skeleton?
أنا بخشك معك لا لا خلاص وكدك عادي ترى
إلى these are the carpal bones okay the pisiform is the little finger corresponds to little finger there is a bone called pisiform PISI, PCFORM, form, pisiform bone. Okay? So this is the fulcrum for wrist flexion and extension. okay. Now
subhanallah, ma fi
fark. Move the arm to the metacarpal. See the metacarpal, okay, fifth metacarpal. Mobile arm to the fifth metacarpal. Stable arm to the ulna, okay. Stable arm to the ulna. Fulcrum in the pisiform bone. Come here. Fulcrum in the pisiform bone. And mobile arm from the metacarpal. So this is neutral. Neutral means neither into flexion nor into extension. So from here 0 or 180 from here, can you do extension? Extension. Okay, that's it. Yes, that much only. That is 180 to 120. So that means around 60 degrees of extension he got. For the flexion again same way. Fulcrum pisiform bone. Stable arm to the ulna. Fifth metatarsal, okay, starting from 0, and I will do flexion, okay. Now here, it is 100 degrees,
yes,
from 180 to 100, that means 80 degrees of flexion, 70 degrees of, 60 degrees of extension, that's what he has in the right side, okay. So to see the left side, can you come this side? Can you keep your hand here? Here. Turn that side. Okay. Keep the hand here. Now, relax. Neutral. Come to neutral. Extension.
Sorry, one.
Neutral, neutral, keep neutral, here, 180, extension, okay, 110,
mm-hmm.
So that means 70 degrees he got here, okay, fulcrum.
More
than the right side, mm-hmm. Here, flexion, that's it, little more,
yes,
around 5 degrees less.
5 degrees less, yes.
Okay, so he got extension here more,
mm.
Extension less there, flexion more there, there, flexion less here.
Yes.
So this is what comparison between right metacarpal, sorry, fifth so metacarpal. Mobile arm to the fifth metacarpal, stable arm to the ulna. Okay, so this is what the positions. Now for wrist, there is another movement, that is ulnar deviation and radial deviation. Okay? Ulnar deviations and radial deviations. So the movement happens like this. Towards the little finger. Towards the little finger it is ulnar deviation. Towards the big finger, it thumb towards the thumb, it is radial deviation. So to measure it, again the same position. Can you come to here? Keep the hand.
What are you doing?
Okay. Sure. Now he need not hang here. You need. He can keep like this on this. He can do towards the thumb is radial deviation, towards the little finger is ulnar deviation. So now fulcrum is capitate bone. Okay, can you see this one? The big bone? Can you see this? This is called capitate bone. So the fulcrum is capitate. So to palpate the capitate, I will bend and I will feel. Can you see? This is the capitate bone. Yes. So I will go there. This is my fulcrum. I will keep the fulcrum there. Okay. My stable arm
with ulna
to the midline between radius and ulna. Yes. The movable arm to the third metacarpal. Okay. Not to the finger. If you keep the finger, finger can move a little bit here, mm-hmm. and there, but metacarpal is fixed. So you have to keep on the metacarpal. Now, exactly 0, 180. Okay, now I will do radial deviation. Okay, how much? 30 degrees, 180 to 50, 30 degrees. Ulnar deviation, around 50, 45 to 50. Okay, so usually ulnar deviation is more than radial deviation. Can you do and see? Keep your hand in front of your face. Move towards the little finger. Move towards the thumb. Thumb. Yes. Little finger. Thumb. Not like this. No. Wrist. Okay? Little finger. Thumb. Which is more?
That's all.
Okay? Little finger is more. So that means ulnar deviation more than the radial deviation. Like external rotation more than the
internal rotation.
Okay? This is about the wrist. So the wrist joint positions are flexion extension, fulcrum is pisiform bone. Medial deviation and lateral deviation, fulcrum is capitate bone.
Capital.
Okay?
Yes.
The ranges are extension is usually 70 per wrist, flexion is usually 90, 0 to 90, 0 to 70. Ulnar deviation 0 to 45 degrees to 50. Radial deviation is 0 to 25 degrees or 30 degrees. So this is what the normal range is for wrist joint. So I want everybody to do for both flexion extension, ulnar deviation, radial deviation, same groups. Okay?
Yes.
And write the same findings between right and left. After that, finish. Okay?
Okay.